Hello again, dear students. In this section, we have a substitution and area between curves. They are both of them. They are important. The area between curve is really the continuation of the total area. So you have a total area. We talk about the total area, and now we are going to talk about area between curves. So it means that we have two curves. So first of all, I am going to really to the area between curves, okay. Then later I'm coming back to this, okay. Later I'm coming back to this, or it's okay. Let me go forward. We have what? We have the substitution formula. When I say substitution formula, it means that we have something the outside has got derivative in the outside. For example, we have this one to understand the main objects of today. We have what? Forget about the boundary, okay? We have this integral. X squared plus 1 over. And here we have a 3x squared dx. Now we have a substitution, means that we have a du and u. There's no methods, it's just imagine that you have a u. Why I say u? Because you can say x cubed plus 1, 1 over 2, 3x squared dx. The derivative, we have two functions, so the derivative of these parentheses, the brackets, we also is already in the outside. How? Because, you know, the derivative, forget about 1 over 2 also, forget about the 1 over 2 so square root. We say this is like a u, so derivative of here is equal what? 3x squared, and you know this one is equal 0. So because the derivative is already here, we can say that, we have, if it's a u, you say u plus 1, u for example, u to power n, you say n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c. We say just because we have this one, we delete, we combine this one as a du. That's why I say we add equal to, without integration, x cubed plus 1 over 1, 1 over 2. So we add 1 and we put into the new new power, and then we put the c. If it's, we have a minus 1 to 1, so you know how to deal with the definite and indefinite integrals. So why we just add this one? Because this part is the derivative of the inside part, so we have inside and outside, okay, u du. That's why this example will be what? X cubed plus 1 3 over 2 over 3 over 2 plus c, which can say 2 over 3 and something else. I'm finishing here. You know this one is equal to our result because we put the value. And forget about the value here. Forget about this value. Really. Do not mention it. Just try to, for example, we have what? We have 1 and minus 1. Now you can substitute it. So I have what? I have 1 to power 3 plus 1. Okay. 3 over 2. We have 2 over 3. This one will come to here. So I get 2 over 3. Okay. And this is the first part minus the second part. The second part is what? Is 1 minus 1 to power 3 plus 1. And I get what? I get 2 over 3. 1, 1 is equal to 2. 1, 3, 2. 2 to power 3 over 2. Minus plus 1 minus 1, 0. 3 over 2, okay? So it's equal to 2 multiply 3, and you know it's equal to 2 to power 3 over the square root, okay? Over the square root. So that's all the value, and the result will be what? The 2 will come to out. The 2 will come out because I have 2 to power 3, so it remains 2 to power 2 will come out. So 4 over 3, 3 square root of 2. Now, it's time to talk about the second example, and he solved it. You can see, forget about this method. Try to understand that one and how to get this method. Now I'm going to the example 2. In the page 8, section 5.3, we have what? We have pi over 4, pi over 2. Okay, cotan phi, theta, sorry, cosecant theta square, d theta. Okay, how we solve this one? how we solve this one. We have a because it's very complicated for you. No, it's not very complicated because you know how to deal with. Forget about the boundary first. We have a cotan theta cosecant square. Now I'm just leaving one cosecant and let the cosecant also what do you say? A cosecant square d theta. I'm just putting this one as here. You know the derivative of cotan is what is cosecant. So if it's u, this one will be what? Du. Okay? If this one's u, this one, this part will be dy, because the derivative of cotan is equal to cosecant squared. That's why it means that you have a derivative outside. So cotan is 2 power 1. Here is power 1. So inside has got outside. So I say is equal to cotan squared over 2. Okay, plus c. Because I have minus pi over 4, we see it's pi over 4, pi over 2, and all this one gone. Okay, so it will be 1 over 2. You can say cotan pi over 2, all of them square, minus of the rule, cotan pi over 4, okay, square again. That's all. Okay, it's equal to 1 over 2. 0 minus minus what? You can pi over 4. I think it's equal to minus 1. And just give me a minute, let me find it using the table. The last things here in this section. In the page 8, we have an areas between curves. Curves means that we have at least two curves, F and G. So the rule is to say that we have F, A to B, A from A to B, F minus, do not forget about G, DX. Tell me about F and G. You should recognize which one of them is upper, which one of them is lower. For example, I have something like that. So this is F and that one is G. How? By the graph I decided, by the value. So in the page, before we go to anything else, in the page, what do you say, in the page 9, we have an example 4 in page 9, section 5.3. He say that if we have y is equal to 2 minus x squared and another y is equal to minus x, so find the area between them. We don't know which one is the f and g, so there is no guarantee. You need to you have to do three things. First of all, you need the algebraic steps. The second, you need graph of both of them. Third, you should find the integral. How? The algebraic, I say, first of all, I say let y1 be y equal to y to pi, because I need to find the intersection and I need to find the interval. So this is very important. You have no, you can see there is no, so algebraic graph and what you say, the integral. So there is no interval really. So in that case we need what we should say, y1 is equal to y2 means that 2 minus x squared is equal to minus x, and we will solve together. I get minus x squared minus x minus 2 is equal to 0, is equal to x by factoring x minus plus 2, 1. So in that case, I will get what? I will get 2, sorry, minus 1 and 2. Okay, so the second step need more details, and do not forget to put the minus 1 and find the other point, and also point, so this one is interval, and also put 2, you get what here, minus 2. Okay, put in the what, f of x, put here, so in anyone. So we have what, minus 1 and 2, and y1 for example is minus x. If I put 1, I get what? I get 1. If I put minus 1. If I put 2, I will get what? Minus 2. So that's why I say the points r minus 1 n1 and 2 n minus 2. So here's the graph, the second step. We have 1 n minus 1, 2 n minus 2, so minus 1 and 1, okay, minus 1 and 1, 2 n minus 2. So, and you know the first graph, that be the first graph, y be the yellow, the blue one, 2 minus x squared. So here's x squared, here's minus x squared plus 2, so I have got something like that. Okay. How about y, 1, y2 is equal to minus x, you know the x is like that, so the minus x is like that. So the area that I want to find is here. So number 3 is the integral area, number 3. Between minus 1 and 2, you can see if we found the boundary, lower and upper boundary of the integral by equaling these algebraic steps. So which of them, g, please tell me. This one's f, why, because upper. This one's g because lower, or by value. So 2 minus x squared will be f, and this one will be g, so minus x. So later you have minus 1, 2, and we have 2 minus x squared, minus minus will be x dx. After the solving the value and you put it here, you can find this equal, the result will be equal to 9, 2. The rest of these steps are easy. You can find in your lecture note. Here you can find all things that needed it. The important things here, which one of them f, which one of them g. Be sure that without algebraic and graph of both of them, f and g, you cannot find the integral. Okay, dear. That's all about the area between two curves. If you have two functions, make sure you have area between two curves. Thank you for watching this movie. This is about 5.3. Later we have a 5.4. See you or in the next video.